With everything in professional wrestling these days feeling like it takes a lot longer than it used to, between how long Monday Night Raw is to how long the entrances are, it got me thinking, what about the longest matches? And the results I found were pretty interesting, which is exactly why it's the topic of this episode. Because today... A major thank you to all of my awesome Patreon supporters such as Edgar Perez, Bob86, and Cool Ass Jack. Thank all of you so much. Alright, the first thing that you might find interesting is that even though everything feels like it's taking longer nowadays, modern day WWE doesn't have an entry on this list. However, the number 11 spot does go to a WWE match with the Greatest Royal Rumble, a bout that clocked in at 77 minutes and 17 seconds and was won by Braun Strowman. This took place on April 27th, 2018, which is just a little bonus entry for you. And that's not to say that a match from the House of McMahon doesn't make this list later on, because it definitely does, but we will get into that in just a little bit. But before we do, please allow me to ask that you make sure that you're subscribed to this channel and that you give this video a big like. Thank you in advance. And with all that being said, let's get into the list. And to start things off, we have Ring of Honor's Northern Aggression, which took place in December of 2011. And on this card, we saw Charlie Haas, Eddie Edwards, El Generico, and Shelton Benjamin defeat the team of the Briscoes, Michael Elgin, and Roderick Strong. This was an 8-person tag team elimination bout, and it took 80 minutes and 33 seconds to determine a winner. And if an hour and 20 minutes isn't enough for you, just remember, this is only the first entry on this list. And now it's time for that match from the House of McMahon, but it's not WWE, but rather it's WWWF. This goes back to the old school WWWF days and one of their Madison Square Garden shows of the 1960s. Unsurprisingly, this bout featured their champion Bruno Sammartino, who's going against Waldo Von Erich. Now, what is surprising is that this bout ended up not with Bruno Sammartino going over, but rather it ended with a very specific kind of draw, a curfew draw if you will. For you see, even to this day, New York has a wrestling curfew, where shows can only go on so long, and back then, 11 PM was the hard cutoff time, where a show definitely had to stop right then and there. It didn't matter if it was for the WWWF World title, it didn't matter if it was in Madison Square Garden, and it definitely didn't matter if it was going on for 81 minutes and was the longest recorded match up until that point, which this bout definitely was. And now it's time to take a trip overseas and to Germany. And the WXW show Road to 16 Karat Gold, which took place in Bielefeld on February 16th, 2019. And this time we have yet another draw, as Avalanche took on Jern Simmons to a no contest after over 81 minutes, just barely being able to top the last match by less than a minute. Next up, we're keeping it overseas, but with a match that I thought probably should take the top spot, but doesn't. This was a huge cross-promotional event, as Big Japan Pro Wrestling, DDT Pro Wrestling, and the Kintai Dojo all got together for the Omisoka New Year's Eve special, which took place on New Year's Eve 2009. And the main event of the show was a match called the New Year's Eve Rumble, which featured 108 participants. That's right, you heard me correctly, 108 participants. And it was won by Jun Kasai, who gained victory by last eliminating the great Kirara. This glorified battle royal took 85 minutes and 12 seconds. And again, I'm kind of surprised it didn't take longer with all these wrestlers. Next, we traveled to the Independent Wrestling Association Mid-South and their show When Hero Met Punk that took place on February 7th, 2003. And as you can infer from the title of this show, the main event was Chris Hero versus CM Punk. This was for the IWA Mid-South Heavyweight Championship, with Punk walking into the show with the gold. However, after this 2 out of 3 falls contest, Chris Hero would be walking out as the new champion. But this definitely wasn't easy to do, as it took 92 minutes and 15 seconds to accomplish. And And now we go from the 2000s back to the 1960s. March 21st, 1968 to be exact. Here we go to the NWA Armorillo show in a match which featured Carl and Kurt, the Von Brauners, who were the champions, going against Dory Funk Jr. and Dory Funk Sr. for the NWA Tag Team Championship. This bout took 95 minutes and saw the Von Brauners coming out victorious and retaining their titles. Alright, so we just went from the early 2000s to the 1960s. Well, now it's time to go back to the future and the year 2005, where on October 22nd, Chikara put on the show The Cybernetico Returneth, which featured an 8-on-8 tag team elimination match that saw Eddie Kingston, Jigsaw, Mike Quackenbush, Milano Collection AT, Mr. Zero, Sabian, Skyda, and Shane Storm take on, in a losing effort, the team of Eric Cannon, Blind Rage, Chris Hero, Claudio Castagnoli, or Cesaro as some of you may know him, Gran Akuma, Hollow Wicked, Icarus, and Ultra Mantis Black. This match took almost 105 minutes to conclude. And yes, this is the second entry for Chris Hero on this list, but it's definitely not going to be his last. And now we go to January 30th of this year and Game Changer Wrestling and their show, Fight Forever Iron Man Block Challenge. This show, fittingly enough, featured Jordan Oliver, the champion, taking on Tony Deppen in a 2-hour-long Iron Man match for the Synergy Wrestling Championship, which Jordan Oliver retained. Now, the second longest match of all time took over 125 minutes. In October of 1987, Antonio Inoki defeated, via TKO, Masa Saito, in a match that took place entirely on an island. This is definitely a unique entry on this list, and as you can see, it's not just because of timing, but also because of location. And now it's time for the longest match in recorded wrestling history. This spot goes to Smash Canada and their fundraiser, which featured a gauntlet match that saw Chris Hero take on 17 different opponents. And in what would be the last match of the gauntlet, Chris Hero would take on Rich Swann, and the match would conclude with a time limit draw. Now, the way this was all set up was simple. Chris Hero would wrestle for 30 minutes for $500 donated. However, he ended up wrestling for 190 minutes instead, as they raised well over $3,000. And Chris Hero definitely lived up to the hero part of his name as he wrestled for over 3 hours, all in the name of charity. Well, there you go, the longest wrestling matches of all time. What's the longest match you can remember watching in person? Let me know down in the comments, and please, again, make sure that you're subscribed to this channel. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, Dave knows.